thank you for joining us tonight for this virtual book launch. I'm absolutely delighted to release this brand new product, Pipe Tunes by John June. The book features loads of new tunes that I've been working on through COVID and all the way back to when I was younger and when I was first composing. We've got loads of exciting performances for you tonight from some of the world's finest young pipers, all playing music from this collection. They've done an amazing job and I can't wait to show you their performances. These players all took the time to make the recordings from their home so that you could hear them from the comfort of your own home. Firstly, a couple of notable mentions. This book production had a number of sponsors. Without them, it wouldn't have been possible. Firstly, to Robbie McIsaac at Flux, who, for those of you that don't know, just released a brand new blowpipe and is something I'll definitely be getting my hands on. Next, John Elliott at G1 Reeds, who has helped me and so many other young pipers progress through their piping and pipe band careers. So without him, I owe a lot of thanks. Jim McGilvery at pipetunes.ca, who helped get me some more of my tunes on the map. And finally, Yori Chisholm at The Tone Protector, whose chanter cap really aided my performance preparation, and I've managed to progress because of that. So without further ado, here is tonight's first performer. This piper from America came second in the US Silver Medal, was a finalist in the 2016 McGregor Memorial Piping Competition, and was placed fifth in the Open Hornpiping Jig in the World Online Solo Piping Championships earlier this year. He really is quite the inspiration, having to learn all of his repertoire by ear. Please welcome Austin Diepenhorst.
What's up, everybody? I'm Austin Diepenhorst from San Diego, California in the United States, and this is my guide dog, Newton. It was a great honor and a real privilege to be asked to be part of this book launch here for John Dew. really inspiring and a lot of fun to get a chance to learn some of his music. So I highly encourage you to get yourself a copy. Lots of great tunes in there. I'm sure you'll enjoy it as much as I have. He is a wonderful composer and it's well worthwhile. The tunes that I started off with were a hornpipe and jig called The Tug of War Disaster at Lochearnhead. And the jig was called Day One Assignment. And I'm gonna finish my set here with a Strathspey and a set of Wicked Reels. The Strathspey is called The Crosty Park, and the reels are called Sniffy Stu, On Mute, and Midnight Fancy. So I hope you thank you very much for listening, and I hope you enjoy the rest of the book launch.
Great playing there, Austin. Thanks so much, and thank you for the kind words. Okay, up next, we're heading north to Canada. The next piper has a huge range of success. He won the overall at the BCPA Annual Gathering in 2016. In 2018, he won the US Silver Medal for Pibroch at the Kansas City Winter Storm. And later on that year, he came third in the Oban Silver Medal as part of the Argyllshire Gathering. He's been a member of the world-renowned Simon Fraser University Pipe Band for 5 years and previously played with Alberta Caledonia for 10 years. Here to play for us tonight, Zephan Knichel.
Thanks so much for tuning in to John Dew's online book launch. I'm Zephan Knichel, and I'm coming to you from Port Coquitlam, Canada. Whew. All right, well, that was a couple of 6-8 marches, written by John, of course, and those tunes are called Dalhousie Court and the Battle of Hamel. Now, if you haven't yet, please make sure to put in your order for John's new book. There's a ton of great tunes in there, and I'll tell you, it makes a great gift. Now, the next set I'll be playing is comprised of 3 tunes. The first tune is a slow march called the Rout of Bonnymuir, and then 2 double reels called Dallerie and Silver Sandy. I had a lot of fun kind of wrapping my hands around these tunes. They're really fun to play. There's a lot of twists and turns and some really great musical hooks, so I really enjoyed learning these, and I hope you guys enjoy listening to them. Thanks again, John, for the opportunity. And I hope you guys enjoy the rest of the show. Thanks so much.
A few moments later.
So much. Enjoy the rest of the show.
Thanks very much, Zephan. Cracking playing there. So, on to our next performer. All the way from sunny Scotland, the next piper is a real emerging talent on the solo boards. He has won numerous prizes in the senior piping competitions in the UK. Most notable include the B-grade MSR at the Northern Meeting and the Captain John McClellan Memorial Contest, the A-grade MSR at London, And earlier this year, last year, he won the B Grade Pibroch at London and then was placed fourth in the former winner's MSR at the London competition. As I say, that was last year. He's also a member of Inverary and District Pipe Band. I think it's fair to say he enjoys playing in MSR, which is exactly what he's going to be starting his programme with tonight. Please welcome Callum Brown.
Thank John for having me on today, and also don't forget to buy his book today as well. So big thanks to John again. So those tunes were compliments to the teaching of Willie McCallum, Dunblane Ceilidh, and Colour Sergeant T. Lindsay. So I'm going to continue on now with a couple of hornpipes and a couple of jigs, starting off with the Anderston Hornpipe into Spearshall Close, and then into some 6/8 jigs, which is compliments to Helen Urquhart, and finishing off with Under the Arch. So, hope you enjoy.
Brilliant playing there, Callum. It's pretty clear to see how you've done so well in such a short space of time. As we head to the halfway stage, I'd like to mention that the book is currently on sale at a pre-launch discounted price and is only available for the rest of this weekend. Also available is my EP, The High Bridge Walk, which was released earlier this year. On sale, on the run-up to Christmas, there is a bundle for sale, which you can purchase the two products together at an overall discounted price. As you can see, it makes a great stocking filler and an even better coaster. Okay, so next up, we're heading down under. It's often hard for Australian or New Zealand pipers to make a name for themselves in solo piping competitions because they have to travel halfway around the world just to turn up. It makes our travel situation in Scotland seem like we're just rolling out of bed and onto the boards, which in many cases is exactly what happens. This piper, however, made an impact as soon as he hit Scottish soil. In 2017, he played in Pipe Idol and his band placed 8th in the Grade 2 World Pipe Band Championships. He got the bug, and on his return in the following year, he was placed 4th in the McGregor Memorial Piper Competition in 2018, and then the next day he won the MSR, the Intermediate MSR at Oban, and then the day after that, he won the overall C grade at Cowell Highland Games. He has since won numerous contests in Australia and New Zealand, winning the New Zealand Silver Chanter in 2017, and he won the Australian A-grade light music competitions in Australia as well. He's also played in the Pipe Band Club and Canterbury Caledonia. Here to play for you tonight, Josh Chandler.
Chandler and I'm from Melbourne, Australia, and I'd like to thank John for this opportunity in this virtual book launch. I just played a set of jigs called Quartet Fever, Watering Vines, and the Falconer. I now continue with a set of round hornpipes called Big Al Mac and Danny the Fridge Factor. Hope you enjoy my tunes and make sure to grab yourself a copy of John's book. Some terrific music in it. Thank you.
Thanks very much, Josh. That was awesome. Just before we move on to our penultimate performer, I'd like to say a few words about piping education. Many of our performers are teachers, and they themselves have received very good tuition. Good tuition is so important in any form of music, and it's so exciting to see how many young pipers and drummers are being produced each year, not just in the UK, but globally. For that reason, I'm selling my book at a discounted rate for any customer who teaches piping or music in any way, shape or form, or is a pipe major in charge of a pipe band or organisation. To claim your discount coupon, please email me at john@johndew-composition.com to claim your discount coupon. This is only available through my website, www.johndew-composition.com. Okay, so to our penultimate performer, again from sunny Scotland, this guy really does have the stage presence of Freddie Mercury. On the solo piping scene, he has won the B-grade MSR at the Captain John McClellan Memorial Competition, the Duncan Johnson, and the B-grade MSR at London. He's also placed second in the B-grade Pibroch at Roseneath, and in 2019, he travelled all the way to Kansas City, where he won the Winterstorm Silver Medal for Pibroch. He also played in Bog Hall and Bathgate Caledonia Pipe Band for what felt like 100 years, but was really only in fact 11. He now plays with Inverary and District Pipe Band. He recently released his debut album, The Roke, and was a finalist in the BBC Young Traditional Musician of the Year. He has performed all over the world, including on the rooftop of Murrayfield, which he tells me was a real honour. There wasn't actually a game on that day, he just fancied doing it, and it only cost him a £1,000 fine. He really is a one of a kind. Please welcome the one truly fabulous, Ross Miller. Thank you.
My name's Ross Miller, and I'm delighted to be here today playing some of John's tunes for you. I started off there with a slow air called The Vineyards of Unang, and then I continued on with four marches, the first one called Cameron Whitelaw, and the second one called Cayley for Callum. I'm going to continue on now with a couple of Weistraspeys. The first one's called The Chimnea, and the second one's called Otago to McFater, which I assume references that journey you've got to make from on the subway from Otago Street to McFater Street on the degree course that myself and John both studied on. And then there's going to be three reels to finish. The first one's called Loose Ferrals, which I hope I'm not guilty of today. The second one's Iain Lowther, and the final one's called Homeward Bound. So I hope you enjoy these tunes today, and remember that you can purchase your book from today. Thank you.
Thanks, Ross. Brilliant playing there. Ross also plays the trombone to a high standard. Unfortunately, when I asked Ross to play all the tunes on the trombone instead of the bagpipes, he turned me down. However, he did say this, and I quote, "John, on the night of the launch, if there are 20 individual comments of trombone emojis on the video by the end of the gig, then I will play a quick tune for you in the trombone and upload it to Facebook on Sunday night. So, get commenting." I thought it was only fair that I play a couple of my own tunes, having asked everyone else to play some of the tunes from this collection. So yeah, I'm going to give it a bash, and I'll be starting with a couple of hornpipes, Connor's debut and the Hamilton Wonders.
Thank you.
hope you all enjoyed the tunes so far. Just before I move on to my final set, I have a few special thank yous to make. Firstly, for all of you who attended tonight. It really is a tough time for musicians, for anyone, and as musicians, we really appreciate any form of kind words or purchases or any form of support. It all goes a long way, you know. So I really hope you enjoyed the music and thank you for turning up. Secondly, to our sponsors, Flux, BagpipeTunes.ca, G1 Reads, and The Tone Protector for sponsoring the book. These organisations, along with many others who I'm sure you all know who you are, have helped me and many others in my career, and I have a lot to thank them for. Madeline Stewart for her design and layout of the book, Andy Coutts for printing the book, and to Pipe Major Stuart Liddell for writing the foreword. Thank you to the performers as well. I hope the tunes weren't too hard on the brain cells. And thank you to Jamie Kabaziewicz for helping me with some of the video editing. The book is available for purchase at a pre-launch discounted price, and also available will be a digital copy of the book for those of you who prefer digital rather than paperback. Please do buy a copy for yourself or a loved one, and as I said earlier, it all makes a fantastic coaster. I'm now going to finish up with a mini medley of three tunes. First, The Roses of Upper Inveroy into Lucky Charm, and finishing off with a tune called Clean Sweeping. Thanks again. I hope you enjoyed your evening. I hope you enjoyed the tunes. Thanks for listening and good night.
Wow, thanks very much. Well.
They're called the Vineyards of Unang.
December, I will be bringing out. Oh my god, this is so hard.
You don't have to yell. You don't have to yell.
Mm-hmm.